we were dealing with issues of global politics and trade. As you know, I have been doing biographies of some of the critical people in the year of 2025 and just beyond that. And it's amazing to me how in my work as a biographer, I came across this one person that tied three amazing women together. You all know him as Sir Thomas the Doubting, but his actual name was William. And he really tied together the work on global politics and trade that happened in these very formative years. So it all started, of course, when the Pope went to China. And as you all know, Deborah was a part of that delegation. Amazing Presbyterian woman there, lifting up the role of women within politics and trade. She had this amazing talk about bitcoins and how they could become a universal global currency. And it was fascinating to me as I did my research on her persistence and her dedication and how she impressed the Pope with the role of women, such that suddenly there was this groundswell of support. And the Pope came out and said, we need women to have a voice in our global politics and our trade, change the direction of the church, and in fact, was critical to Deborah's further work when the PCUSA went to the UN to talk about these global trade issues, and the Pope supported her, and it became an ecumenical Christian movement relying on economics of Jesus Christ and how that would work. And we all know that St. Thomas, aka William, was there saying, I don't believe it, it's not going to happen, I can't believe it. And we know that the doubters were there and he was among them, strongly and firmly among them, and yet he saw Deborah's amazing work and was just fascinated by how all of this was working. Well, you all know that it was just about that time that Martha went as the chaplain to that amazing Middle East summit that seemed to be working. Things were happening as the leaders of these countries were talking to one another. And we know that Martha's prayers were critical in the work that was going on there, and that she was able to again, give this voice to the way that Jesus was performing. But she was not alone there, because with Pat speaking and bringing together the youth and the children, this was the first summit that they ever had where the children of leaders of all of these countries were brought together and they played together. And it was impossible for the leaders in that room, the men and the women, to say that we cannot get along when their children got along. With Pat and with Martha working so diligently about this, we know the tragedy of that moment. And we know that when the American president was assassinated, the horror and the misery and the retribution that was planned in that moment. Again, St. Thomas, aka William, was there saying, I don't believe we can get through this. I think that this beautiful moment where we could have come together has been ruined by this tragic event. And Martha offered her prayer. A prayer that was the prayer of Jesus Christ, that we offer forgiveness in the face of this tragedy. And the children that Pat led, with their show of solidarity and support, leading to an outpouring around the world, an offering of letters, finally turned our hearts to what we as Christians have said all along. We are in this together. And it was because of the work of these three amazing women that we can stand here now in 2275 and see what has happened. And we all know that St. Thomas, aka William himself, cried when he saw that indeed it could be done. Thank you.
Awesome. It's going to be a tough act to follow.